and go for a party, don't have a drink that you have kept on the table or who, I mean, did we ever learn such things?
Yeah.
And the, of course, the boy is also one. I think more than teaching him, I think he learned by example.
Right.
How we, how Shirish treats me, how his sisters are treated at right. home. He's probably outnumbered, so, you know. So, yesterday he had a singing competition and normally when he competes with the boys, he gets kind of defensive and says, oh, I sang well, but yesterday he came, he said, I don't think I'm going to get. I said, why? He said, the other singer was better. I said, really, how come? So she was a girl. So she performed better than me.
So he knows who's going to rule the world. Yeah. So I think this generation of boys...
I think he knows that. I think you have to start teaching the boys. And then you'll have a whole generation of men who are...
Comfortable
and not being what you call toxic masculinity or whatever.
Because
so,
there's a lot of it.
Yeah, but then I think we have to start with our boys.
Yeah.
You know, the girls are, and of course you have to teach the girls to assert themselves.
Yes.
And to not let anyone kind of rough it out over them or tell them any better.
What about this whole culture of star kids? You have quite strong views on that as well. Because eventually
I just
your
feel it's not their choice, yeah.
Star kids. But,
you know, who is to be blamed? They say everyone wants to see them, which is why their photographs are taken, right? And everyone laps it up. If nobody wanted to see them, they wouldn't be stalked outside
right.
schools and play dates. And because everyone wants to know what this one's child looks like
doing,
or what are they doing. Sad. It's a voyeuristic society now. What can you do?
So how do you prepare your kids for it? You can't.
You can't stop them from, I need to take them out and give them a normal, we go to supermarkets, I
right.
go personally to do the grocery shopping for the month and we'll go to Warsaw Beach sometimes and sit there, people will come, take a photo, they know now, sometimes they tell me, Mama run, Indians are coming when we are abroad. Spotted Indians run, but I am not running.
Because that means a lot of selfies.
Yes. So that sometimes they do resent it, but they are
like that.
Yeah.
It's a
crime. Yeah, because they'll see and then they know that they've recognized Mama. But I think you have to make them as normal as possible.
Is the industry still very male dominated?
Not
is
at
it,
all.
Really?
I don't think so. Male. I don't.
Is it still not about the male superstar?
It's about who brings in the maximum money. So
no
now you can
gender.
Blame the rest of the country, you know, for that. Because who patronizes the movies? It's not the industry, you know, it's
right.
the country. It's the people who want to go and see that movie. So the whoever brings in the biggest money will be the biggest superstar. The minute the women start getting in the big bucks, they will be the superstar. It's a business
model. Do you think there will be women who will follow?
I think
shows?
At some point there will be, you know. Everything changed quite a lot, no? From the last 30 years also. Everything
you were talking
changed.
Of a time when you didn't even have washrooms for women.
We didn't have washrooms, period. But the men could go and pee wherever they wanted.
And you had to hold.
We had to hold. Matlab. Let's not discuss it.
But I think that's...
I have very strong kidneys.
The years of holding your self.
Yeah, because when you went on an outdoor,
yeah,
there was no vanity van culture.
Right.
You know. And that poor heroines also had to change
behind
some towels, hold some towels and things like that. So a lot has changed. And a lot will change even more.
I've been asked to ask the one question and then I'll be opening it to the floor. And please do ask some questions. I've been asked to ask her. Where do you get your kurtas from? There's
who,
a fan of yours
who
in Delhi.
Asked me?
No, a fan of yours in Delhi who said, I want to go to the same person.
Oh, okay. I don't know which one. I stopped wearing kurtas long ago. But,
never mind. It's just a...
Ranangil, I think.
Okay. Any questions from the audience, please? Everyone wants to know that.
Nahi picture.
Nahi picture, agle saal, inshallah, I should not say what.
God willing. Almighty willing. Any more questions from the back?
What a good audience this is.
Very
very subservient.
Yeah,
and
they
docile.
Don't. They have no questions. They know everything about you.
Oh, yeah, wow, we ask something to Kaveri also, yeah.
No, I'm quite tired.
No, I want to ask her something.
Okay, let's have a question, yeah.
यहाँ पे किताब का नाम है नो रिग्रेट्स
जी
ऐसी कौन सी फिल्म है जिसको देख के आपको रिग्रेट्स हुआ
मेरी खुद की या दूसरों की
किसी की भी
मैं वो नहीं बोल सकती हूँ मैं कैसे बोलूँ कि द आइडिया इज एवरीथिंग इज एन एक्सपीरियंस राइट सो आई कैन से तीसमा खान और बट आई हैव नो रिग्रेट्स एब्सोल्युटली नन व्हाटसोएवर आई हैड अ ग्रेट टाइम मेकिंग द मूवी That's the movie where I made my maximum money because we were also producers.
Right.
So I have no regrets and we should.
And you got Sheila Fitzgerald out of it.
Then we should go by the title of this book.
Yes.
Yes. You should learn everything. If it doesn't work out, learn from it and make something else work.
But do you have any regrets in life? Apart from your movies. What are you funny? Not that your movies are regrets.
That was very bad.
Sorry. But do you have regrets? Things that you think that.
No. I'm not a sorry, regretful person. Like if I think, oh, I could have. No, like you feel regrets like if, oh, you. I wish my dad would live longer. But that's not something I could control, right? You're saying in terms of.
Yeah.
Like, do you have any?
No, not really. I think I've just given up. Either I have selective amnesia,
yeah,
which I think is a very useful
it's
tool.
Very good.
You should practice that, and I consciously practice that. Or you should just, as you said, chalk it down to experience. I think
yes,
everything
live and
learn.
Yes, everything it either will make you happy or make you learn.
Yeah,
something.
What doesn't?
So why
kill
did you choose this title?
Because of that what doesn't kill you always makes you stronger. So.
But it's a strange title for a book on motherhood and lessons of being a...
Because I think as mothers we carry so much guilt around us and we have this whole burden of perfection and we're told all the time that, or at least even if we're not told, it's understood that we have to be perfect at everything that we do.
That is
and
true.
It's not possible. And I think it comes out of all those years of PTMs, I don't know if
yes.
you... All those years of PTMs and being made to sit on that little chair like a naughty child and being told your child has not done this, your child has not done that. So this is like my revenge.
Yes, I think the book says it all. I don't think, I definitely don't have any regrets. In fact, some of the most regretful things I've done in life are the most fun. So
we will not go into that.
That's
maybe.
Not, that's another book.
But yeah.
So I have a question for both of you. Farah, when you started out, you were literally the first Indian female director that we knew and we looked up to.
There were quite a few before me, but yeah, okay.
Kaveri, you're the first woman editor of
yes.
India Today.
Yes.
So for both of you, were there things that you had to change about yourselves in order to be heard and to have your point executed?
To change about ourselves?
Yeah, in male-dominated industries.
I'll go first and then maybe Farah. I think I really had to convince myself to speak up, you know, because I think as women, we're so used to just doing our work and then going on to the next thing. You know, I had to learn how to, in a way, market myself. I don't think I did a very good job, but at least I tried to sort of, you know, sort of, because men talk more, I think.
And do less.
And
yeah.
Do little.
Sorry, Eddie, not you.
Except everyone except the men here. But in my case, it was that. I don't know about Farah.
I didn't change anything about myself, which I think was good. I was a loud mouth. I used to say what I felt like. And I think it, in the long run, it only helped me. Because people saw over the years that she is what she is. And if she's saying something, you may not like it at that time, but she is not bullshitting. She is so I didn't bullshit, and I think because of that, lot of things change. People will accept you as you are. After you give them some time, and they. But if you start changing yourself, then you lose yourself in that. So I think
But did you get advice to change? Did people tell
not
you?
Not really.
Don't shout so much, don't throw so many things.
Who would dare to tell me? I'll be shouting at them all.
I have a question. Hi, I'm Smita. So I know that you're the first choreographer who directed the slow motion song, Pehla Nasha, right? So that was something that you did different. And then how did you build the confidence to move into direction? I'm sure you would have had a lot of naysayers.
You know, I came in wanting to be a director. So I never wanted to be a choreographer, though I had a background in dance and I used to choreograph shows and I was a dancer, untrained. But I came because I wanted to. So in Jojita, I was an assistant to the director. It so happened that the choreographer couldn't come for the outdoor. And because I was the only person there who had some experience in song and dance, so it was just a matter of just being at the right place at the right time. But for years while I was choreographing, my angst was that now I have to make my movie. You know, it's been 10 years and I came to be a filmmaker and I haven't made a film as yet. So it took some time before I made Mehmuna, which I'm glad because I learned a lot while, you know, when you come in full of foolish confidence and then over the years you realize that maybe that was, I would have made a shitty movie if I had started out 10 years earlier. I learned so much more to make a polished product by that time. But so that was it.
This is to the choreographer. I watched the old movies, Pakiza and Bobby, where Arunadhi has the dance.
Yeah.
But none of your dance, not you personally, but dancers today have that rhythm in the dancer or the music.
Yes, that is true because I'm sure when Bobby and they came, the 50s people said the same thing about them and said, "Hamari zamane mein bahut grace." See, the thing is, it changes. You can't complain because the music changes. The taste of the youth changes. People who are now watching hip hop and this, they want the music has become that. Unless you get a song like that, how will you choreograph something graceful?
No, I'm speaking about the dance steps matching the music. It really does. Believe me, if you just watch something like Pakiza, Chalte Chalte, it's mind blowing, even today.
That is true.
Same for Bobby's song, which Aruna is dancing on, Bachare or something that song is. How beautifully she goes with the music.
That is true. I think they would probably give more importance to interpreting the lyrics. Well, today is Coca-Cola to me, how will you interpret the lyrics? So you will have to give a hip hop step.
And mask the lyrics.
Yeah, so it all depends on what kind of song you get. You know, I personally love to do love songs. I wait for like a beautiful love song. So we will say everything is hip hop and that, but you can't really complain because every generation before always complains about the next one. So I don't want to do that.
Which is your favorite love song that you've choreographed?
Oh, I have choreographed many, which I have choreographed. I think there were quite a few in 1942, a love story.
Yeah.
Then there was one in Happy New Year, which I really like, Manwa Lage. I thought it was a really differently short love song, and of course, quite a few and Om Shanti Om, there was Main Agar Kahun, so and Aankhon Mein Teri. So I love doing these. I love.
Yes.
As a parent of young kids, I've really been enjoying your sort of thoughts about bringing up children. And I was wondering about, because now that they're 12 and a bit, did you say you've already given them phones, and how do you tackle phones, internet, all that stuff?
They've just been given the phone by their grandmother, who is my mother. The thing is, I protested and held on for very long. I just feel it's like a safety net now. It's been used to know if they are there or if there's any problem, they can call mama and dada. They have it. I think at some point, I have given in to that this technology I cannot stop, because everyone goes hyper about screen time and all, but when they grow up, this is how life is going to be, right?
Yeah.
So I guess when television came and everyone said, what TV is it? But Our parents must have said, "Bahut TV dekhte hain ya bahut radio sunte hain," someone must have said. But that's how life is going to be. That's what I said. So the struggle is always of how much to give and how much not to give. I can't make them clueless about technology because finally,
they need it.
You have to see 6-month-old babies now, 1-year-old. Fully swiping right on which app, I don't know.
Are you guilt-free?
Mothers will never be guilt-free, yeah. Kaveri, you know that. I think once the child comes out of you, the guilt gene is pushed inside by the midwife or the doctor, whoever. So at no point we can be like the dads, completely guilt-free.
Yeah, you think they are?
Completely guilt-free.
Yeah.
They can go for one. Shirish went to make his Netflix movie, called us not even once. Guilt free, happy, but because he knew I was there.
Right.
But if I go and he's there, I know he'll probably do a better job than me, but I still have to call every night,
yeah.
And even to just know that they're missing you. But yes, the first time I went to work, I think my children were 2 months old, and I was just howling in the van, crying. Came
yeah.
back, they were had milk and they were sleeping.
Thank you so much.
Thank you
everyone,
so much everybody.
For being such a patient audience, for listening to us. I'd like to ask, I think, Shabnam.
We had a little something for you, ma'am.
Oh, lovely.
Just for you to hold now and
okay.
then we'll take it later.
And then you'll take it back?
No,
yeah,
we'll give it back to you.
This is like a TV show hamper. They give it for them and then they take it back.
But do they ever give it to you? They give it back or?
I can't answer that question.
What a question.
They have to use it for the whole season.
Thank you so
much.
Something for taking time out for.
Thank you.
And then I'd like. Yeah. And then I'd like to request all the women and men in my life, I think they know who they are, to come on stage and
some strange ones may come up, you never know.
To come on stage and we'll do a quick photo op because it's Farah Khan, she does end credits.
Yes.
Everyone has to be in the end credits. Pooja, Edi, thank you.
Thank you.
Kaveri
is always very good at getting all the food.
Thank you. So, Pooja, Gayatri, Suzanne, Prabhat, nice to. No, we'll perhaps do it here. Yeah. So, I hope. Have I forgotten anyone, please?
Thank you.